infolive.tv, live on your mobile phone. Do you want to keep ahead of the news and receive updates on what is happening in Israel? Infolive.tv offers you a unique service: regular video news updates free of charge on your cell phone. To sign up, enter our website at www.infolive.tv and click on the mobile services banner. News update for InfoLive TV. This is David Oman. Security forces in Lebanon are on high alert Sunday during by-elections to replace two assassinated members of parliament from the anti-Syrian coalition, Walid Ido and Pierre Gemayel. The elections are unlikely to change the overall balance of power in parliament. However, they will test the popularity among Christians of the Free Patriotic Movement. Spanish Foreign Minister Miguel Moratinos has requested a meeting with Prime Minister Ehud Olmert to convey a positive message from Syrian President Bashar Assad, with whom he met in Damascus a few days ago. It is reported that Moratinos heard interesting ideas from the Syrian president regarding resumption of negotiations with Israel. Ahead of the Jewish New Year, the Counter-Terrorism Bureau warned Israelis Sunday against visiting Egypt, Jordan, Yemen, Lebanon, Syria, Iraq, Sudan, and Somalia due to a risk of being abducted by Hezbollah. The Bureau pegged the risk level as high and concrete and pleaded with Israelis who are already there to leave at once. Russian Naval Chief Admiral Vladimir Masorin said Sunday that after completing testing, the Russian Navy plans to commission a new intercontinental ballistic missile next year. The Bulava-M missile will be submarine-based. At least 20 people, including 6 civilians and 10 police officers, were killed in violence across Afghanistan over the weekend, according to police. Afghan President Hamid Karzai arrived in Washington, D.C. on Sunday for talks with President Bush on the deteriorating security situation in his country. Some 30% of the AK-47 rifles and the pistols given to the Iraqi security forces by the U.S. are missing, raising concerns that some have fallen into the hands of Iraqi insurgents. Some 190,000 weapons were given to Iraqi forces in 2004 and 2005. Israeli construction company Heftziba Group will file for temporary bankruptcy at the Jerusalem Magistrate Court on Sunday and present a recovery plan. The court will hear petitions by the company's customers on Thursday, who fear they will lose their apartments, dozens of which were occupied by angry buyers over the weekend. Join us on a tour of historical downtown Jerusalem, where the presence of the 19th century great powers is still felt. Today, the whole world talks about Israel. But who broadcasts from Israel to the world in four languages, live from Jerusalem? InfoLive TV, the first international Israeli television channel that operates 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Follow current events in Israel and the Middle East. Video features, interviews, news programs, and news briefs live as history unfolds. If you want a direct link to Israel, access InfoLive.tv.